Right, today we are doing a damp survey. That's a stunning listed building here with some damp issues going on. So we're going to go through some basic stuff. So, as you can see here, I will put a picture into this, but there is an old culvert under the ground there that is completely flooded. And we have got one downpipe in the corner here, completely blocked. We've got another one, you see I've broken out down there, completely blocked. And we've got another one, completely blocked there. You can see, you've got a pipe there, just down there, going through the wall. And again, that's just discharging onto the ground. It's a little bit blocked as well, to be fair. And if you come through here, to this gate a minute, down to the side of the house, you've got some high ground levels here. And there's high ground levels all around the property as well, to be fair. So they want lowering down. And this one here, there's a lot of water coming off this roof. Goes down to there, discharges there. The sound detection, so we know exactly where we're to, and that is that white pipe. So you've got these two downpipes basically discharging there, suspended timber floor there. It's getting a little bit whiffy. Keeping it very, very simple. Gazebo today, it was supposed to have been hammering down, so I was very fortunate, wasn't too bad. You've got a lot of damp problems inside there, and you can just see there's the end cap missing on that one there. Blocked hopper. And we've got here a shallow inspection chamber. Fill up with water. So that is from that downpipe there. You can see there's a lot of green stain in there. This was over like that at one point, it's just running down the back. So that a little bit of detailing and something like that. We'll come back to this one in a minute, it's quite interesting. This one here goes off to here. And there's another pipe, we don't know where that's going, another drain going across here somewhere, I don't know where that's going, but I'm told there's a well there, I think. When it's snowing, you can actually see the well there, where it must be a little bit warm, it'll get a bit melting. And then here you have a block drainage here, and we've got three pipes, they meet here, three drain pipes there, and all of them just need a little bit of mortar in there. Straight away. End cap missing, that end cap is actually blocked as well. And then this one in here as well, where the connection goes into there, there is no proper connection and everything is just literally just running down. Obviously it's wet in now. Again, you've got the waste pipes, really want to be turning it into the gully. And then this downpipe here goes all the way across here. We've got a beautiful balancing pond. Goes to there. Look at that. If I lived there, I'd have a couple of carp in here and I'd be fishing. Right, and if we come all the way along back here again, this is where it gets a little bit interesting. So, as you've probably seen if you look at any of my videos, everybody claims to be doing this and doing that, but you just got to keep things very, very simple. Like, this building's had a lot of lime done inside and out, and it's gone wrong. So, there's a drain there, and that's where we just come across down there. Look at that, flooded. So you've got five drain pipes going through there. Every single one of them is blocked. Come down into the yard down here. I'll put a picture of this, but again, there is all blocked. Here, we've got some land drainage, and there's two pipes there going off. One of them, if I remember, is correct, blocked. That's done to another neighbouring property. And this all goes over this way somewhere to a ditch. There's an old drain there, it's redundant. So again, we don't exactly know what's going on there, but obviously part of the planned works is getting all of this rectified by keeping it very simple and fixing these problems. Right, so you see I've done a pretty good survey, to be fair. We've identified a lot of high level issues with the aerial camera, guttering defects, block gutters. It's a, you know, common problem. Without looking up there, you can't really eliminate these things. So it's all about elimination. Then we drop down to the lower ground sort of areas, and we're looking for high ground levels, bridging render, which all this property had, all the basic stuff there, but the drainage is really paramount in moving forward. Lots of issues there, block drains, you know, some of this stuff, if you haven't got the cameras, if you're a homeowner, just flood those drains. You can buy some cheap drain tie, chuck it on in there and see what happens. Best tip I can give you, when it's hammering down rain, get out there with an umbrella and watch that building. It will tell you what's going on. After you've had very heavy rain for a long time, still go outside, have a look, pond in water. It can tell you possibly sometimes when you've got drain defects. I was very fortunate to find the well. And what you can also find, what I also found was, well, there was some sort of pipe coming on. Now, what I have found in a lot of older buildings, there's land drains put to them. So I've got a lot of really old books and bylaws and stuff like that, probably all for my local area. And a lot of these buildings, they had land drains put in as part of their regs back at the time. And obviously this one here had a culvert as well. It's probably going off to the balancing pond. It's full up with debris and silt, as to expected, on something that's not been maintained. So realistically, we've identified these causes, it all needs to be fixed. Internally, the customer has got degrading plaster, rotten skirting boards, like typical of, you know, rising damp symptoms. What is really important now is to do the plaster sampling. So there's some methodology out there called BRE Digest 245. And that's basically tells you to actually differentiate what's going on between rising, penetrating, dampness, that and you have you. So what you can do is drill a vertical profile at the wall, and you can look at the distribution of moisture and see the pattern, and you can actually ascertain exactly what's going on by capillary moisture and hygroscopic. What is really important about this is now, is we can see the blue line is the capillary moisture on the graphs, and it basically goes off like that and then goes up. That means it's wetter at the base, so I think it's about 5-6%, then it drops off to nothing. The hygroscopic value in a couple of the places is different. I think, I can't remember what it was now right looking at it, but you can see exactly the same sort of profile, sometimes a little bit jagged, then goes back up. The reason we need to test for that is because a long-term rising damp complex, you would typically get a lot of nitrates and chlorides. Now, in this case, that is what we've got. So what is important is, because I deal with a lot of flooded buildings, I deal with a lot of older buildings like this that have had rainwater goods just rammed into the ground and literally just soaking the ground. So in this case, this building was like sat in a moat. you can imagine it's just sucking all that moisture up. Now, sometimes what you can actually find is, if you've got, like say, a mains water leak or clean water from like rainwater goods, whilst you've actually got what looks like a rising damp symptoms now, which you have, right, it's actually quite cheap to fix, because sometimes, and I would say sometimes, you can literally fix the issues, dry it down, maybe a bit of decorative painting or what have you. But in this case, unfortunately, the plaster's damaged, so the plaster can have to be replaced as well. So this becomes expensive. But if you could imagine now, a lot of people have had works done to buildings, more modern buildings and like old ones like this, and hasn't actually identified the root cause. So my job from this client was to identify root causes. We've done as best as we can on this type of survey, but you know, some of these drains were blocked up. How bad do they need some of the replacing, or can they be repaired with some lining, some patching? I don't know about that. It all needs to be all cleaned out. So you can do as much as you can, as I feel like I've done now, and then we can give some better guidance on repair. Right, so before I go, if you like this type of video, give us a subscribe, but I'm gonna put the graphs at the end of the video so you can basically stop and pause it, whatever you wanna do, so you can actually look at the graphs. I've got some great videos coming up. on some really interesting stuff on damp from years and years ago, some of which, of what I know, nobody's ever heard some of this stuff. Really interesting stuff. I've got literally, probably, I'm looking at them now, probably about 150 books, like really old stuff. It will be interesting if you're a bit of a geek, but yeah, give us a subscribe, look at the graphs at the end. Any questions, drop in the comments below and I'll do my best to answer them as soon as I can. But thanks for watching, see you soon.